swirling madness. It reminded me of the Dark Presence, just another memory, but it could still kill me.
Ha! No! Fuck!
Stupid. Please have that TV be like a
trick. Just another memory.
Yeah.
But it could still kill me.
This is crazy. This can't go on for much longer. It's freaking nuts what's going on here. No. Bastard. See, I hit jump there and it didn't jump. Thankfully, it wasn't an issue, but I could have died there. No?
Stay focused on the lighthouse. If you reach it, you will find the cabin.
Things are getting pretty crazy.
It's to be expected. You are struggling to reclaim yourself. The landscape reflects that strain, but each step takes you closer. If you persevere, you can attain the lucidity that fends off the darkness.
Well, that worked out. Ah! Alrighty. Done. Alrighty. Was pretty sure there was something else that I could grab. Hooray, a checkpoint. Hole. I'll do. Ha! Nice. Got some for me, TVs? No? Welcome to the party, kids. Looks like we're dropping. Alar? No? Okay.
Wake was forced to run through a maze, hopelessly sprinting in the wheel, never getting anywhere. His life in miniature. It was useless.
You're useless. I'm better.
Oh, now what?
Having to run uselessly in the wheel, you know. This is cool. The fuck? It doesn't quite work with the engine. Typewriter letters, fun. See, if you're at the wrong angle, you can't use the stairs.
Mr. Ray, can I help you with anything?
No, I'm good, thanks.
Let's have a look at your hand, Mr. Ray.
Please! God damn it, I said please!
I like how this game plays with light and darkness. I think that it could do it in more ways. Oh, shit. Oh, no. Okay. Take the plunge. Behind the freaking wheel now. Good. Okay. So I'm gonna kind of wait for things to balance out more. There we go. This is a cool idea. I like this. All right, so I'm here again. What does that mean? There we go.
The elevator? Sure, why not? Next stop, Sanity.
You're doing well. Keep going.
It's hard to make sense of this place.
It's a dream. This is a vast place. Home to forces and beings that are completely alien.
The Dark Presence.
Yes. I don't know what happened to it after your final encounter.
Is there any way out of here?
Sometimes transmissions can be sent between worlds. You've done this yourself. But to actually leave the dark place, I haven't found a way.
All right.
Stucky's gas station. It's something I particularly wanted to see, but obviously I wasn't the one to see.
Another memory made real. Wake would never make it. The insanity he was facing was already a part of it, in him, his own doing. He couldn't possibly win. He didn't even want to.
No.
At least the lighthouse was much closer now. I would have to make my way up there somehow.
Ah, crap. That'll do. Oh, I can't get up there. Oh, you gotta be kidding. Ow. All right. Up by the stairs.
There was no power to the log lift.
Alrighty. Cross the bridge and we should be doing better, because we need to get the power. The power! Unlimited power! And such. You know they're gonna come back. There's gonna be bad guys up here. I wonder if they have a camera default thing that I can change. Graphics? No. Background opacity? Oh, I think it's going to a predetermined path, yeah. Got it. I thought I was actually controlling it there for a second. But I wasn't. It was a lie. That's a lie. That's not true. She's lying to you. Or no. That's not true. That's a lie. She's lying to you.
The part of you that is in control is in the cabin, dreaming and insane.
I don't think I like that.
No, that's probably
you
bad.
You represent the part of Alan Wake that is capable of rational thought and planning, which is why I'm talking to you. If that part can regain control, then you have a chance of making it. But a part of you wants to give in. There's comfort in the oblivion of dreams.
Oh, of course.
You represent the part that isn't ready to quit and die.
Wait! Are you telling me I'm not real?
You're as real as anything else in this place.
So there are two of me?
Not really, but yes.
And the one you called Mr. Scratch, he's me as well?
No.
Zane, are you playing some kind of game with me?
I am not the author of your story.
How can you say that when you wrote that page about me and the Clicker? It wasn't one of my pages. You directed me to it. You had Weaver guard it.
Yes, she was needed, and you needed the Clicker, but I'm not.
What? I don't understand.
Ellie, you should keep going.
Zane? Zane, come on!
Well, that cleared things up.
Right. Fuck you. I bet he enjoyed climbing up there. He's like, yeah, I'm gonna give. Oh no. Bye. Assholes. Because I'd rather the camera be over his right shoulder, but it keeps defaulting to left. There doesn't seem to be a way to change that. Try to hit only boom, not crumble. Dang it. Owies, you bastards. Alrighty.
A moment,
Zane.
I can help you here. Fix the foolish mistake I made with Barbara.
Rock. Oh no. Oh lord. I do like that they gave Night Springs like an actual canon reason for existing and why it actually kind of shows things that are actually real. Because it's actually a way for people to report to the Department of Control what's going on. I think that's a cool. A little thing that they did there, and it makes me excited for Alan Wake 2, because that means that Alan Wake is going to tie even more to Control. Flashbangs. Or no? Really? Oh well, I have 15. I hate these stupid birds. Make me want to die. No, not that bad, guys. No, no, no. No assholes. Stop it. Back off, assholes. Owie.
Good.
Wake ran for the light. It was pointless. He would never reach it. His life would be snuffed out just as easily as the very thing he thought would save him.
Even with the light gone, all I could do was keep going.
We'll turn it on. It'll be fine. This doesn't make me upset at all, the precariousness of this. It doesn't bother me. It doesn't give me vertigo, even though it's a video game. Alrighty.
You have a lot of problems, Alan.
Hello.
Since we're being so frank here, Alan, and let me just reiterate how happy I am that you've had this breakthrough, I would like to summarize your condition.
By all means.
And please, just let me know if you think I'm being unfair.
You're being unfair.
Well, let's start with the obvious. The car crash. Untreated head trauma. All due respect to Doc Nelson, but he's hardly a neurosurgeon. I think that the injury has affected you more than you realize.
Yeah, I have had bad headaches.
Then there's your history of substance abuse, which, combined with your chronic insomnia, has resulted in hallucinations and extremely poor impulse control. That's a dangerous combination, one which your wife has unfortunately had to suffer from far more than you.
I know she has.
I don't think I'm exaggerating when I say that you are existing.
That's kind of annoying having to hold it for this whole cutscene.
Denial. Your vivid fantasy casts you as a heroic victim and allows you to skirt responsibility for your own actions. It allows you to solve your imaginary problems and dismiss the things that truly trouble you. In your self-serving delusions, your personal problems are assets that allow you to save Alice, perhaps even the world.
Dr. Harmon, I think that's spot on. I can't argue with any of that.
Well, I'm sure I'm stating the obvious. I don't want to labor the point, but, well,
No, I understand. It's important that I face it.
Precisely, Alan. You've put so much effort and imagination into this self-deception, but what good has it really done for you? You refused my offer of help, and here you are. Did being so obdurate really get you to a better place?
Obdurate.
No. And did it really help Alice? Was this really the best thing for your wife?
Yes.
Probably not.
Why don't we find out? You know, I've been talking with her. There's something she wanted you to hear.
Oh, hey. That sounds like fun.
It probably won't be.